All right, hello everyone. I'm Sheriff Marcos Lopez with the Osceola County Sheriff's Office, and thank you all for being here. Last night, we issued warrants charging two suspects with a murder that occurred here in Osceola County 2 days ago. These warrants have been served, and both men are currently in custody. On January 21st, at around 1 a.m. in the morning hours, we responded to a home on Doncaster Court in Kissimmee in reference to a reported shooting. When we arrived at the scene, we located a white male on the ground with multiple gunshot wounds. The victim was identified as Stephen Jesus Perez. On the scene, our detectives found multiple shell casings on the road and in the grass next to the front door of the residence where the incident occurred. Our detectives started an investigation and learned that this incident began as a family member, as family members got together for a birthday party. At the celebration, an altercation arose outside the home between three men that were in attendance. According to the witnesses, the physical altercation had escalated to a gunfight, then escalated into a gunfight. Afterwards, the two suspects involved in the incident fled the scene in a black vehicle. My aviation unit responded to the scene and was able to locate and follow the black vehicle. During the surveillance, multiple subjects were observed exiting the vehicle and entering a residence at Brookstone Drive in Kissimmee. Two subjects were observed running to a nearby pond and throwing items into it. These items were later recovered, and our detectives found that a black pistol was thrown to the pond. This pistol was positively identified by one of the suspects, Maximo Mercado Jr., one of the shooters, as the gun that he used to shoot the victim. During Maximo's interview, he initially stated that he threw the gun into the grass in the front yard of the residence after he used it to shoot at the victim. However, he later said that he took the gun with him from the scene when he fled. A second suspect was also identified as Liam Nicholson. Liam admitted to fighting with the victim. Liam said he ran to his car to get a gun after seeing the victim allegedly brandish a firearm. Liam admitted to discharging his firearm from within the black vehicle, and then Liam and Maximo drove away to Maximo's house. Based on the investigation, Maximo shot Stephen multiple times, ultimately killing the victim. Evidence showed that the victim was shot while he was retreating to get away from Maximo and Liam. The suspects fled the scene with the firearm, returning to Maximo's house. The suspects then took one of the firearms and used it to commit murder, one of the firearms that he used to commit murder, and threw it into a pond to hide the evidence. Maximo confessed to shooting at Stephen and removing the gun from the scene. Witnesses in this case have disclosed that during the car ride at the house, Maximo discussed that he needed to discard the firearm. Liam assisted Maximo in fleeing the scene. Liam also confessed to shooting a firearm during the incident and punching Stephen, the victim, before he was ultimately shot and killed. Yesterday on January 22nd, Maximo Mercado and Liam Nicholson were arrested by the Osceola County Sheriff's Office Violent Crimes Unit for the homicide of Stephen Jesus Perez. Liam Nicholson has been charged with the following: principal to murder in the second degree, accessory after the fact, discharging a firearm into an occupied dwelling, tampering with evidence, and battery. Maximo Mercado was charged with second degree murder, discharging firearm into an occupied dwelling, tampering with evidence. I want to thank my deputies, patrol and the violent crimes unit, CSI investigators, and the state attorney's office. You know, they helped put this packet together and get enough to arrest these individuals and lock them up. We just want to appreciate the time and effort that everyone put into this case and to come to a very rapid conclusion and closure. Take in mind, there's still other avenues that we're investigating, looking into in this case. It's still an open investigation. Hopefully the victim and the family will be able to get justice. Let me just say it in Spanish real quick. Spanish only? Okay. Básicamente, enero 21, como en la mañana, respondimos a una residencia en Doncaster Court, en Kissimmee. Había una llamada que hubo un tiroteo. Cuando llegamos nosotros, encontramos un individuo, Stephen Jesús Pérez, fallecido. Le habían dado par de palazos al cuerpo y falleció. Empezamos la investigación y unos testigos dijeron que se fueron en un carro negro. El helicóptero estaba en el aire y pudo alcanzar el vehículo y lo siguió hasta una residencia en Kissimmee. Y cuando el carro para, gente entran a la casa y otra gente van corriendo hacia un laguito que había y los vieron, observaron tirar par de artículos en el agua que después fue descubrido que fue un arma de fuego que utilizaron en el crimen. Máximo es uno de la gente que le dimos los cargos por asesinar a la víctima. Él confesó que él fue el que mató a la víctima y tiró la arma de fuego adentro del lago. El otro individuo confesó que él estaba ahí, él golpeó a la víctima primero y la admitió que lo ayudó a irse en el carro a la fuga y él tiroteó el arma de fuego de él en el aire. Basado en esta investigación, hemos dado los cargos de asesinato a Liam Nicholson, el principal asesinato en segundo grado, y Máximo Mercado lo cargaron con segundo grado asesinato. Y le damos gracias a todos los oficiales envueltos, el estado de la Florida, todos los detectives, el buen trabajo que han hecho para arrestar a estos individuos bastante rápido, en como 48 horas. Take some English questions.
Sheriff, you said this happened at a birthday party. Are you able to go into how the two suspects know one another? Are they related in addition to the victim as well?
They all know each other through family friends. The only individual that was a stranger is the Liam individual. I believe he was visiting or was brought by Maximo, who lives here in Osceola County. I think they picked him up in Tampa and brought him over to party.
Do we know why the fight ensued in the first place?
There's different versions of the fight, either disrespecting someone at the party, over a girl. You know, I assume there was a little bit of alcohol also involved, you know. And, you know, every time you get that combination of stuff together, sometimes it doesn't end well. And in this case, one person lost their life.
When that fight changed into gunfire, how many people were armed? And did the victim return fire?
Well, one of the suspects is alleging that the victim brandished a firearm. Okay, but brandishing and pointing are two different things. We all know this. And we haven't been able to have any witnesses at the scene to say, yes, we did see him brandish a firearm. All we know is that the suspects shot at him. One actually went to his vehicle to retrieve one. So, you know, it doesn't look like this was the case. However, we're still looking into it, but according to everything we've gathered, it's nothing like that.
So both Mercado and Nicholson were armed and they were firing at Perez, the victim?
Maximo Mercado was the one that fired at the victim several times and killed him. Liam went back to the car, shot his fire, either to the ground or to the air, and that's one of the things that he admitted to doing.
Then both hopped in the truck,
in a car,
to a house,
yes.
And then ditched the weapon. And
yes,
pond.
Yes.
And that was recovered by you guys?
Yes, our agriculture marine units went out to the area where our helicopter observed. I mean, they have really good capabilities of seeing people in and out of cars. They can even see tags from that distance. And they watched them, and the guys actually confessed to doing so.
Sheriff, this wasn't a child's birthday party, was it?
I don't know what kind of birthday party it was. You know, just a birthday party, a lot of people, family gathering, you know, and that's all we have right now, this information.
And then just to clarify, you said Nicholson did push him or kind of disorient him ahead of the shooting?
I'm sorry, which one?
Nicholson, Liam?
Nicholson supposedly battered him or pushed him, and then that's when everything went downhill from there.
I feel like we've done a couple of stories recently in a very familiar situation, right? One person kind of disorients the victim, kind of beats him up, starts with a fight, then the next one shoots and kills them. What are your thoughts on seeing this?
Cowards, thugs, punks, you know? They don't know how to fight fair. You know, fist fights are the fist fight back in the day. That's what we used to do. Now things have changed. People have firearms. They have anger issues, and they don't know how to handle themselves or conduct themselves in public. So when you have these type of people that are dangerous running around in our communities, these are the things that happen, you know. But they're arrested and they're in jail, and hopefully they'll rot there for a good amount of time because we don't need these people here. And one of them comes all the way from Tampa to stir things up. If you come from Tampa, you want to go to Disney World, enjoy. But if you come from Tampa and you want to look for trouble, and you start shooting it up after you drink all that gin and juice, guess what? You're going to be arrested. You're going to go to jail. You're going to be held accountable for what you do here in Osceola County. Spanish? ¿Tiene una pregunta? Nada. ¿Estás seguro? You had one?
We also heard that a about 6 months ago something else had happened at the same location. Do you know?
I heard about that. I don't have the exact details of that. I don't know if it was 6 months ago, 6 years ago. There was some type of altercation there where there was a case similar to this, but I don't have the exact details on that. But we can get it for you. We'll get with you after this is over, and we can get you the exact details on that.
Sheriff, you said Maximo is from Osceola County?
Maximo is from Osceola County, yes. He lives in the area of Remington.
Is he known to the department?
Well, you know, he doesn't have a big criminal history. Neither subjects do. So that's what's odd about this. But, you know, like I said, you know, sometimes the mentality, this thuggish mindset that you can go around doing these things and the alcohol doesn't help, and or whatever else they were on, and that's when these bad things happen.
Can you speak to the fact that the sheriff's office was able to pin this down within 48 hours of it happening?
Yes, you know, we already had these guys very soon after it happened. What we do, though, is now, working with the state attorney, we start collaborating all the stories, and we take our time to make sure this case is put together properly. And once we get everything put together, we send it to the state. They look and they say, this is good. We effected the rest and issued the warrants. So these are the kind of things that we do to make sure that in previous cases, the state was accusing us of doing shady or bad work. We never have, never will. But now that Bain's in office, we're all on the same page and working hard to make sure we continue to keep these people locked up and our community safe.
Any gang affiliation on either side?
I don't have any history on that, if they were in gangs or anything like that. Like I said, they have very minimal criminal history.
This is down near Poinciana, right, where it's considered a Kissimmee, I guess?
Yes, remember, there's some parts that are in Polk, Davenport, but it's all there. The area where there were is Osceola County.
Do you have an age for the victim?
The victim, Stephen Jesus Perez, was 31 years of age.
Thank you so much.
Is it Stephen with a P-H or a V?
S-T-E-V-E-N. Is that it? Everybody good? Enough? Okay. Well, thank you very much. Have a good day.